What you guys got, another video here for you. In this one we're going to be taking a look at this error message, which is 0xC0000098. As you can see on the screen there, it's also got the information: the Windows boot configuration data file does not contain a valid operating system entry. We're going to be taking a look at how to fix this on Windows 7 and Windows 10, but it does affect any version of Windows, whether it be XP, Vista or 8 or 10 or Windows 7. It doesn't really matter what version you're running. This is a pretty common error message, and I'll just show you how to fix it. So you can see here, this is the error message on Windows 10 as well. As you can see, it's the same error, but it's a slightly different background, blue background. That's because it's a more modern operating system. But you will need a Windows disk, USB flash drive or a CD to boot to. So let's boot up to our BIOS. This is the older type BIOS. We need to go to boot, CD or removable devices, which will be your USB flash drive, and click save configuration. If you've got the more modern BIOS here, then you need to click one of the keys below to get into your BIOS, then go to settings, then boot. Once you're in there, you can choose whether you want to boot to CD or USB flash drive. First off, I'm going to change the legacy mode to legacy plus UEFI, so it's easier to boot to. I'm going to save this. I'll leave it on that by default normally, and then change the options here. You can see CD, DVD or USB flash drive. I'm just going to choose the USB flash drive here, but you can choose either one of the above as well, CD or DVD. Click advanced. I'm just going to check the USB configuration just to make sure that legacy mode is enabled, and it is, so that's good. So now I can then save this configuration and boot to our Windows 10 or 7 disk here. So we'll just save and exit out of this. Now our boot order has been changed. You can see push any key to boot to the disk, and this will then start to boot up to our Windows disk, as you can see here. And we'll do the Windows 7 one first. Now once this boots up, you'll get an option to install Windows. Click next, but we don't want to install Windows here. We want to click on the repair your computer. Click on that and it will do a scan on your drive, and it should detect that you've got a problem. You see it says Windows found problems. You can look at the details here, and you can see name Windows Boot Manager. It's highlighted that there. Now what you need to do here is click close and repair and restart the computer. This will then do its repairs and you should be hopefully fixed and get to your desktop. So we'll just boot up to this and then I'll show you what you do on a Windows 10 or Windows 8 machine. And that also includes 8.1 as well. So let's take a look here. You can see it's right up to the desktop here. That has now been fixed and resolved. So let's quickly boot up to our Windows 10 or Windows 8 or 8.1 disk or USB flash drive. Get the same window. Click repair your computer. That's important, but slightly different. We need to click on troubleshoot here, advanced options, and you should see startup repair. Click on this and it will fix some issues with your Windows. Click Windows 10 and this will then start to diagnose your system and hopefully fix and resolve those. Anyway, my name is Brian from brightechcomputers.co.uk. I hope you enjoyed these videos, guys. If you do, then hit the like button. Also hit the subscribe button if you want to keep up to date when I upload new videos. Also, if you've got any problems with computers or any video requests, you can head over to the forum. It's free to join over there. And also, if you haven't joined my Facebook fan page, you can pop over there and give us a little like up over there. It helps out a lot. Anyway, thanks again for your continued support, guys, and I shall be making more videos again in the future. So thanks again. Bye for now.